Good evening. Welcome to another Live from the Living Room session here on twitch.tv/livefromtheLivingRoomGigs. My name's David Burns. I'm the host of the channel here. And every Wednesday night, we have an hour of live unplugged acoustic music from a different featured artist. And this week, my guest is Sean McGeoch. And I'm going to hand over to him for our first song.
Yeah, this is a song of my own from an album brought out in 2015. The song is called Back to Earth. It's normally on a piano, which I couldn't bring up the stairs today.
That's a bit of a climb up to come up with. Yeah. It's enough carrying the guitar up here.
Maybe next time.
From set the table from the night before, you could start a science project from the remains of what's in show. Just remember as you walk out of the door, the way you feel the how are you today? 'Cause you're looking kinda rough. I would certainly have thought so, as I'm sure I had enough. Just remember as you come back down to earth, the way you feel the night. Delicate and broken as you breathe in the northern air, you could do a lot of damage as you're floating in despair. Just remember as you build back up your walls, the way you feel the night. Can you still grow when all of your roots are dead? You could spend all of your lifetime just locked inside your head. And just remember as you crawl back in your cage, the way you feel the night before. The night before, the way you felt 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 the night before.
This is Live from the Living Room Gigs, and we have tonight Sean McGeoch here live in session. And if you've got anything that you'd like to ask us, then you can use the chat room if you want to say hello. Leave us a wee message that will pop up on the screen here. We'll read it out. And if you want to ask what any of the songs are about, or what gigs are coming up, then please do get in touch. So we've got Sean McGeoch here live in session, and what should we have next from you?
I think we'll do a little cover of Neil Young.
All right, yeah.
Take a bit.
On the wall, they make me look up from her big brass bed. Now I'm running down the road, I try to stay up somewhere in her head. The woman I'm thinking of, she me all up, I'm so down today. She's so fine, she's in my mind, I hear her calling. See the lonely boy out on the weekend, tries to speak and can't begin to say.
Fantastic stuff there. I've You've clearly got you've got a fan here because Tinker's been wandering around already. Usually she's a wee bit kind of hesitant when somebody comes in new, but she's been wandering around already.
Oh, I'm pleased I made a good impression on her, to be honest. Famous Tinker.
That's a great version of that. So it's always found it quite interesting when people come in and when they're doing a cover, what ones they've selected. So is Neil Young, is that someone that's an influence on your songwriting?
Yeah, definitely a huge influence. I actually didn't really get into him until maybe 3 or 4 years ago. He influenced a lot of the artists that I was into when I was younger, I think, and then it was like a natural progression to go back the way, you know.
That's always quite a good way of finding artists. The bands that have influenced your influences.
Yeah, totally. That's definitely the case with Neil Young. That's the way it kind of ended up happening. But once I got into him, it was pretty much no turning back after that. It was like, it was a huge influence on me. And I still listen to him regularly, you know.
I have to say, it's not somebody that I actually know a great deal about. Is there a good kind of starting point you could recommend?
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, it depends where you want to start. I mean, you're looking at sort of After the Gold Rush is a good album maybe to start with. Harvest, it's kind of earlier stuff. My personal favourite album is On the Beach, which was part of his Doom trilogy. Uh-huh. When he was going through a pretty rough time in his life, so that particular album is a huge influence on me, definitely. So that's definitely a good place to start, I would say.
I've definitely got a bit of a musical blank there. I've heard lots of people that have been really really into him and have cited him as references, but has influenced a great number of songwriters.
Yeah, no, I think he's name checked a lot. I mean, I guess particularly any kind of maybe alternative folk or alternative rock or alt country stuff, like, you know, most of those artists have probably, you know, got some kind of influence from Neil Young, whether they know it or not as well.
All filters down.
Yeah, totally.
And you see with the number of people that he's influenced, that have gone on to influence others themselves.
Exactly, totally. I mean, you know, you look at Radiohead, for example, they were a huge influence on me growing up and still are, but, you know, I maybe don't listen to them as much anymore, but Tom York's voice, I think, was, you know, it's made one of his main influences with Neil Young, and musically as well. You know, they talk very highly of him. He seems to have influenced a lot of people, definitely.
You're good self included. And shall we hear a wee bit of that influence in one of your own songs? So what are you going to play for us next?
I'll do a new song I've been working on. So apologies if it's
always good to hear new songs.
Scrappy. This song's called, loosely called Under the Lights at the moment. A lot of my songs are kind of, I guess, facing up to some truths within yourself or something. This song's very much about that and trying to reconnect with people that you've maybe fallen away from. So that's what this song's about.
Hello, you're my hero. I'm sorry I let you down. Sometimes I forget the price I pay trying to make it as a clown. And I've lost my head once or maybe twice. Every single time I come back up, it's like I'm rolling another dice. We hope you can see us when we're at our best. Every single time we make it home, we've passed the test. It's hard. You see. And of course, you see, you're just like me. Jesus knows some card tricks. He shows you when he likes. Maybe you should come and join us here under the lights. And maybe in the morning you'll come strolling by, solidify our reconnection with a movie. Seldom in my hands, I will spend the rest of my lonely life trying to be a better man. It's hard, you see, and of course. You're just like me. You're just like me.
Beautiful song, yeah. Thank you, Sean.
Thanks, man.
Just to say, viewers in the north might be experiencing some sound and vision interruptions. This is Tinker climbing all over the equipment and knocking the camera over.
I was trying so hard not to laugh at this.
Oh, see, I was struggling to keep that together there. That was, so if you're watching and wondering why the camera suddenly moved off, Sean, it's that cat again. You're sitting there playing this beautiful heartfelt song, and I've got Tinker climbing all over me.
I have to say, I take it as a compliment. I think Tinker's just trying to get involved here. You know,
she just wants to be star of the show.
She is the star of the show. There's no denying that.
She loves the limelight, that one.
Yeah,
but you are supposed to be the star of the show tonight. So what are we going to have for me next?
I think I'll do a song by Dylan. This is probably kind of famously known in The Big Lebowski, the film. And started off as a bit of a comical thing playing this. I was playing in Lebowski's in Finistone, and I was like, I've got to play the man in me by Dylan.
Has to be done.
Yeah, and then after I played it, like I was just going to play it that night, and I was like, I actually quite enjoy playing that, so I've kind of been playing it ever since. So
Dylan and the Coen Brothers, it's what can go wrong.
Exactly. It's a match made in heaven. So yeah, this is the man in me.
Ooh. there's a little he would ask. Take a woman like you to get through to the man in me. And storm clouds are raging all around my door. Think to myself, I might not take it anymore. Take a woman like your kind to find the man in me. Oh, what a wonderful feeling just to know that you are near. It sets my heart reeling from my toes up to my ears. The man in me will hide sometimes to keep from being seen. Just because he doesn't wanna turn into some machine. Take a woman like you to get through to the man in me.
Version there. She's coming up again. Tinker, are you gonna knock everything over again? Right. Yes, you are.
Yes, she is.
Right, let's get the camera.
Simple answers to that.
Back onto you. And just what I was gonna ask just before Tinker leapt up and sat on the mixing desk. We just heard a little bit in that song of the little gizmo you've got in there. A little bit extra percussion. Now, I had never seen one of these before until I borrowed your guitar to play at an open mic that you were hosting.
That's
and
right.
Discovered you have this tambourine built into your guitar.
Yeah, it's a bit weird to me as well. I'd never seen one before. As a friend of mine bought me it. It's a bit weird. I was saying to you earlier on before we started that you can only really catch it in the upstrokes.
Uh-huh.
You can get used to it, but I guess it's good for jamming and house parties, but maybe not so practical live. But
that's a nice wee extra bit of sound.
Yeah,
to it.
It's cool. Yeah, I'd never seen one before. It's called a jamboreen.
And
you can get them online. I think they're only like 15, 20 quid or something like that. So
that just kind of like clips in around the sound hole.
Yeah, you just take the strings off or loosen the strings. And place it in, and then it's sort of, you just have to kind of squash it in, and it just stays around the sound hole. So, yeah, it's good fun.
Cool. I'm hearing a weird buzzing sound. I think the cat's knocked something. So hopefully, it's not too
much going into the broadcast.
I'll try and fix where that bus is coming from as we go along, but it's going to be one of these nights where the Tinker has decided she wants to get in the way because no one's paying attention to her. Because Larry got all that attention, number 10 cat, when they got the police to open the door to number 10 the other day, and the cat was all over the news, and this one is jealous about another cat getting
starting
attention.
To make sense. So now the cameras are rolling.
Now the cameras are rolling.
Their opportunity.
On. Yeah. Now, are you gonna sit nice and let us get on with the show? Are you? No answer. Right, down you go.
If you want to come up and do a song, Tinker, that's absolutely fine.
are we cat duet?
Yeah. What was I gonna do? I may actually tune for this one. The dreaded tuning.
Whilst you tune, I'll see if I can work it with this buzzing noise is coming from. And whilst you're doing that, I'll just put up a wee film of all the guest artists that are coming over the next couple of weeks. I think I've found what connection the cat had knocked and started making that buzzing noise, and Sean is tuned up. So what are we going to have next?
Okay, I'm going to do a song by Fairport Convention called Who Knows Where the Time Goes.
Cool.
It's one of my favourite songs of all time. A song I regularly come back to in times of distress.
What is a song for if not for in times of distress?
Well, exactly.
It's the mark of a good song is the one that you can come to when everything else is going wrong.
Exactly. And it's I think the lyrics in this are just, you know, they just transcend everything really. I'm pretty sure everybody could relate to what's going on in the song. So yeah, it's one of my favorite songs.
What was it called again?
Who Knows Where the Time Goes.
Who Knows Where the Time Goes, yeah. Fairport Convention.
Here we go.
Across the evening sky, all the birds are leaving. Oh, how can they know it's time for them to go? Deserted shore, your fickle friends are leaving. Oh, but then you know it's time for them to go. Who knows? time goes. Who knows where the time goes? My love is near me. And I know that's so, until it's time to go. By the fires of winter, birds in spring again, I do not count the time, for who knows where the time.
Fantastic stuff. Sean McGeoch with his version of Fairport Conventions, Who Knows Where the Time Goes. You're watching it live from the Living Room Gigs, and we've got Sean here live in session playing a wee unplugged set tonight. We do this every Wednesday night, live music here on this Twitch channel. And we mentioned earlier on that you're hosting some of the open mics and playing gigs around Glasgow.
Yeah.
Do you have any gigs coming up? Where can we catch you live just now?
At the moment, I have a gig coming up in March of next year. I haven't actually announced yet. If you check me out on Facebook, then you shall find out. Hopefully next week, actually, I'll probably announce it. Just frantically going, trying to get everything organised, as always.
Just making sure everything's all set in place before you can announce it. Yeah,
I mean, I haven't really done a lot of my own gigs for a while, like, you know, actually playing my own stuff properly. So, I decided I had to give myself a gig to give me some kind of deadline for some stuff I'm working
something
on.
Something to work towards, yeah.
Because if not, then I'll just keep writing songs and scrapping them and writing songs and scrapping them till the end of time.
But you get something that you have to be working towards, and you know, you've got to have the...
I've definitely found that, like, I did that with... I brought out an EP earlier on this year. It was like an instrumental EP. And I'd had some of those songs for like 2 or 3 years. And it got to the point where I was like, seriously, I need to actually
have to do something with them.
Yeah, so I just like set myself a date and I was like, right, that's it.
Is there a link where we can find that?
Yeah, so the stuff I've released previously is under the name of Stada Zagora, which you can find online. It's on Spotify and there's a couple of videos on YouTube, and then the usual social media, Facebook, Instagram, all that sort of stuff.
So we'll link to that on the Live from the Living Room Facebook page.
Thanks very much.
On. I'll get a note to, of that.
Yeah, it's a bit of a, bit of a weird name.
I'm trying to work out how to spell it.
So it's Stara, and then Zagora. Stara Zagora.
Yeah, I'll get a note of that from you later on.
Yeah, I think we'll go. It might be easier.
And then we'll put that up onto the Facebook page from Live from the Living Room. That's facebook.com/livefromtheLivingRoomGigs. And where you'll also find this video if you missed it live when it was going out on Twitch. All the sets get archived on the Live from the Living Room Facebook page. So we've got that coming up in March, which will hopefully be announced pretty soon. And yeah, and the instrumental EP there. Cool. Get the guitar tuned up. I can't
I'm
imagine.
Not quite
how...
sure what's going on here. I've done something very weird with the B string.
Trying to keep a guitar in tune at the moment when it is this cold.
I know exactly. Yeah, and then I think when you're obviously putting the heating on and off as well at home, then it's just like the wood's just expanding all the time. It's an absolute nightmare.
Just doesn't want to stay in tune at the moment at all, does it?
It's getting there. I think I did something daft there.
I've had exactly the same thing when I've been busking. The guitar's just they don't like it. They don't want to.
Yeah, and when once it starts as well, you're like, oh no. The longer it goes on, you know. That's fine. I can play with you. I'll just go with that.
Just bend into it. Almost there.
That E string just does not want extension. Right. Okay. I think that's not bad.
That's close enough for jazz.
Yeah, we'll go with that. So I think I'll do. I haven't played this in a while, so hopefully I don't. I can't swear, right? hopefully I don't mess it up.
If there's any young kids watching, just cover your ears for a minute.
No, hopefully I don't mess it up. This is a song by The Flaming Lips.
Oh, yes.
Do You Realise?
Lovely song.
Yeah, one of my favourite tunes. And I haven't played it in a while, but we'll give it a bash.
Thank you.
to everyone. You know, someday we'll die. And instead of saying all of your goodbyes, let them know you realize that life goes fast. It's hard to make the good things last. Realize the sun doesn't go down, it's just an illusion caused by the world spinning round. Do you realize that you
I absolutely love that song. It's one of my favourites.
I love it as well. I completely messed it up, but that's because I said that prior to the song.
Live TV, these things happen.
Yeah, totally. The best time for it to happen.
Just go with it.
Yeah. But yeah, I love that song. I haven't seen the Flaming Lips are a band that I'm sad to say I've never seen live, but you know, they seem to be one of these bands that you have to see live at some point.
I'd love to see them live. Yeah. I've seen videos of their live performances, and it's
like a total spectacle every time, you know.
Yeah,
which is great. I don't know why, it's just circumstances. I've never been able to go anytime they've been playing over here. So
yeah, just the way it works out. They were on the bill at Tea in the Park.
That's right.
The year that I was there, and I'm trying to, were they the band that pulled out?
I'm trying to remember.
So I think something happened to somebody.
What year was that?
It was 2003, I think.
Yeah, I think my brother was at that. I think, I'm sure he said something about they had to get the drummer in on a screen or something. He had like pre-recorded all his parts.
Something had happened.
He was on the screen at the back of the stage, which he said was really weird, but also really cool. I don't know if it was that year, but I think it was.
I just have a very vague recollection of them being on the bill and wanting to see them, but ending up watching the Polyphonic Spree instead.
Not a bad substitute,
to be fair. Not really. No. They've got a fantastic show too.
Yeah, totally. They're another band that were just sort of infamous for their live shows, big spectacles, you know.
Yeah, you don't see anything like that very often.
No,
pretty much like a whole orchestra and choir and.
Totally, it's very rare. Yeah. Could do with more of that, to be honest.
Yeah. Can't imagine it's the easiest thing to organise.
I've
enough trouble organising a three-piece band. Yeah,
exactly. Or even a duet, it's hard enough.
Yeah.
Hard enough to get things organised, so fair play.
Absolutely. So we've got about 15 minutes of the show left.
Okay, cool.
Should we have some more music? And
what will I do? I think I might do Landslides by Fleetwood Mac.
Alright, yeah.
I'll go for that. I was kind of debating about playing another song, but I'll go with this, I think. So yeah, that's another song that's I love. Just a beautiful song. So yeah, take it away.
To my love, to go down, climb the mountain and I'll turn around. If you see my reflection in the snow-covered hills, till the landslide brought it down. Mirror in the sky, what is love? Can the child within my heart rise above? Can I sail through the changing ocean tides? Can I handle the seasons of my life? Ooh. Well, I've been afraid of changing, 'cause I build my life around you. But time makes you bolder, even children get older. I'm getting older too. I'm getting older too. Afraid of changing, 'cause I build my life around you. And time makes you bolder, even children get older. I'm getting older too. I'm getting older. Took my love, took her down, climbed a mountain and I turned around. If you see my reflection in the snow covered hills, till the landslide brought it down. If you see my reflection in the snow-covered hills, till the landslide brought it down. Oh, the landslide brought it down. Oh, the landslide brought it down.
Great stuff, Sean. So this is live from the Living Room gigs, and this is Wednesday night songwriter session, and we've got Sean here playing live and unplugged, and we've had a great selection of covers from you with your songwriting influences. Yep. Can we hear something of your own?
Yeah, sure.
Some original music.
Yep. What song was I gonna do? It was.
Hang on. Here comes trouble. The cat's back.
Please feel free to steal the limelight right now while I navigate through this new song.
She might wind up trying to take over mixing duties again. Because the mixing desk gets warm.
She seems pretty skilled, to be fair. You know, I think she's had a lot of practice at this.
She does it better than me sometimes.
I think she's maybe practicing while you're out.
She must be. Get you on and you're keeping you out to work as a sound engineer.
Okay, this is a new song that I've been working on. I've played it a couple of times when I've been out and about. It's called God Shook Hands with the Devil. And it's a song about coming to terms with your own dark side that we all have.
Yeah.
And just being at peace with it, I guess. That's the vibe.
Alright.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
God shook hands with the devil. They were tired, feeling aimless. They were tired of being fair weather friends. Now they surf the rising tides till the end of time. When you're all alone with your madness, floating on a river of silence, and you call. You get no answer. You just surf the rising tides till the end of time. We all need myths. You can pray your whole life would just get up and start again. Oh, 'cause God, oh, 'cause God is a state of you can scroll your whole life just talk, just let them talk. Oh, 'cause God, oh, 'cause God is a state of mind.
Beautifully played there. That's a fantastic song. We're just coming up to towards the end of an hour. We've got about 5 minutes left, so I think we've got time for maybe one more. And cool. Just before we do that, just quickly see, we've got two shows coming up in next week. Next Monday, we've got Matt Johnson coming in to do a wee session with the Narcissus Cookbook, and Emma Durkin is coming in on Wednesday for the usual Wednesday songwriter session. But to finish off tonight, back to Sean, and what should we finish the show with tonight?
I think I'll go for something a bit more upbeat. It's a song by Big Star, one of my favourite Big Star songs. Gonna go for 13. Yeah, just again, just one of my favourite tunes. Go-to songs for Big Star.
And so if one of our regulars, Ross Morris, Ross Kovacan, is watching, here we go, here's a Big Star song for you. He's a massive, massive Big Star fan.
Nice one. I'll try not to murder it. Nice one.
That's a Big Star cover there from Sean, and thank you very, very much for coming in and playing tonight's live session.
My pleasure, man. Thanks for having me. Yeah, thank you.
It'd be great to hear you playing, and we'll get the link put up to your music. What was that again?
Status Agora, but I'll write it down for you.
I'm not trusting myself to spell that right.
I don't trust myself to spell it right. So, but yeah, like I say, there's going to be an announcement of a gig. Probably next week I'll announce it. So
keep an eye out on your Facebook page for news.
If you're interested. I'll hopefully have a full band on the night as well. So it'll be less depressing.
There's nothing wrong with a good depressing minor key.
Well, the right place and time.
I'm sure Tinker agrees as she's been circling around you all night.
It seems to have calmed her down a little bit, so
thank you.
Thank you so much, man. Yeah, cheers for having me.
A pleasure. And as I say, we'll be back next week. We've got two live shows next week. We've got Matt Johnson coming in to talk about his Narcissus Cookbook album Moth on Monday night. And Emma Durkin's going to be coming in to play a session on Wednesday. I've been David Burns, live from the Living Room Gigs. Thank you very much for tuning in. And I'll see you again soon. Take care and good night.